Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the React Document Editor component using the Create React App command and Syncfusion EJ2 React Document Editor package. Using the React Document Editor or Word Processor component, you can create, edit, view, and print Word documents. The key features supported are open and save documents, insert table, image, bookmark, shapes, and so on. Please check these features list from the UG link provided in the description below. I will show you how to configure a few of its basic features like enabling toolbar, opening and saving documents. Let's start with the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest version of React and Node in your system. I'll use VS Code as my editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. I'll create a new application in the command prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name my react app. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, I navigate to the desired location and install the Syncfusion Document Editor package using the command npm install @syncfusion EJ2 React Document Editor. Then, I open the project in VS Code. Here, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. Open the app.css page. Remove the default CSS styles and reference the Bootstrap 5 CSS styles to apply them to the document editor component. Before using Syncfusion components, you need to register the Syncfusion license key. Open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, register the trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, a license key is mandatory for React projects to avoid license warnings. Next, I open the app.tsx file and import Document Editor container component from the EJ2 React Document Editor package and include the Document Editor container component tag. To add custom height to the Document Editor container, I add the height property and set its value to 590 pixels. Let me run this application using the command npm start. Look here, the document editor is rendered with a properties pane, and I can write any content. Here you will find options to format the text. I'll change the font size and apply the style to italic. These options are used to format paragraphs. I apply the heading 1 style to the title and align the heading in the center. Next, let me show you how to enable the toolbar with predefined options. To do that, I import the toolbar and inject modules from the EJ2 React Document Editor package and inject toolbar module into the document editor services. I add the enable toolbar property and set its value to true. Look here, the document editor is rendered with a toolbar. The toolbar has options to include an image, table, link, comment, and so on. You can hide or show the panel by clicking this toggle button. Here, I insert the image by clicking the Image button. Click Upload from Computer and select the image. I can include a table using this button and provide the number of rows and columns to insert the table and type the content just like a Word document. I can also insert the comment by clicking this Comments option. Here, I will provide the comment details. I have just shown the limited document editor features from the toolbar options. But there are other toolbar options similar to Microsoft Word. Let me show you a few important ones. You can add a header and a footer to a document. You can design form fields and protect the document from unintentional editing. You can also add the table of content like this. Track changes and accept or reject changes in the document. Using the Merge Document toolbar button, you can perform a mail merge operations. I will explain these features in my upcoming videos. Meanwhile, you can explore them on the demo page linked in the card above. Next, I will show you how to save a document from the word processor. I hold the Control key and press the S key to save. As you can see, the Word document is saved on my machine. Notice, the saved document format is SyncFusion Document Text Format, SFDT. And this document format can be only viewed using the SyncFusion Document Editor component. You don't need to write any explicit code to open or save the SFDT format file. So, click the Open button from the toolbar and select the SFDT document to be imported. So far, I showed you how to open and save SFDT documents. Next, I'll show you how to save a document in DOCX format using an external button click. I add a button with the text, Save. I add the onClick event and assign the callback method, onSave. I define this method here. To access the built-in methods of the Document Editor Container component, I declare a variable editor object of type Document Editor Container component. Then include the ref property and initialize the editor object. Inside the onSave method, I use the editor object instance to call the documentEditor.save method. Here I need to pass two arguments, file name and file type. I pass the name as sample and type as docx. Next, I add inline style to align the button and set margin bottom to 10 pixels. Check now, when I click the save button, the document will be saved in the docx format. Finally, I will show you how to import this docx file using the service URL. To do that, I'll add the service URL property and assign the hosted URL link of the server project. Let me open the GitHub location of the server-side project, which has the import API. In the Document Editor controller, the import method is used to open the docx file. Apart from this import method, this controller has a few other methods to paste the clipboard format, restrict editing, to save a file format other than SFDT and DOCX, and to check the spelling. Let's see the import method in detail now. Here, the memory stream is used to store data in bytes. Based on the document input, the document type is identified and copied to the stream. The load method of a Word document will be used to convert the stream byte array into a Word data format. Then, the Word data will be converted into a JSON object and will return to client-side. Using this method, you can also import EMF and WMF images. You can download the GitHub location of the Document Editor controller from the link shared in the description below. Click the Open button from the toolbar and select the docx file to be imported. Check now, the docx file is open. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the SyncFusion React Document Editor component using the Create React App command and how to use a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.